We press pause on our liaison. She promises to hold me later. When the day has washed over me, I can bask in her glow. What's your go-to-bed ritual? She puts on a show and we say goodnight to each other. I smile at what's left of her. What's your biggest fear in life? I won't be there to say goodbye when she sputters out. When she sputters out. When she sputters out. I'm told there's no need to worry about it yet. Thank you. My eyes don't even recognize my eyes. Sometimes squint at each other in the mirror. And my eyes don't know what color they are. They communicate conspiracy theories through blinks. Gray. They fall into my pupils. They dilate as an act of passive aggression. Never open their arms to each other. My eyes don't even recognize my eyes. Sometimes squint at each other in the mirror. Whether they both close together or in regular intervals, they interrogate each other every morning at the dressing table. One tear duct rebels at an alarming rate. My eyes don't even recognize my eyes. Sometimes squint at each other in the mirror. Lips are suspicious of them, how they can see. Yet they remain unseen. I barely bounce off them, more just sway around, with gravity as my only constant. I don't close my eyes, peel them back with duct tape stuck from lashes to lids. I never get very far, as many steps forward as back. An artist could interpret me as a modern Newton's cradle, but really, between you and me, I'm not nearly as ambitious as that. There's no greater understanding behind my rolling. Algorithms and numbers still scare me as much as they did back in GCSE. The wood feels more plastic with each knock. And I worry, perhaps I'm really just stuck in an IKEA unit. I question how many meatball-fingered children have held my soul. But that store doesn't give much room for hesitation. It's the Swedish equivalent of supermarket sweep. You rush whether you want to or not. The cafe holds as much solid as the Texaco on the airport. I keep my hands clasped shut, tight to my chest in corpse position. I know, if I fall, this isn't the optimum choice, but at least my pockets are so shut with anxiety. I wonder what would happen if the wood split and splintered, nearly missing a vital organ. But I'd like to think my blood no longer splatters but trickles, like the brook in the field behind my childhood home. With liquid mostly stagnant, every movement feels too gentle to be alive. Those two sticks we dropped held the weight of every choice I've ever made. I let them drift downstream as slowly as they might. Their grain glistened against the sludge. Thank you. dog out for her morning wink. And once I can finally pour myself out of bed, I'll make breakfast for all three of us. Dictate and drive, sometimes taking your hand off the wheel to hold mine. I want to do boring things with you. I don't need a fancy restaurant or flowers on my doorstep. Don't say what you think I want to hear, or reciprocate declarations just to keep the peace. Only say what you mean, and know that's all I want to hear. Let's take delight in a food shop. Find Lidl's frozen aisle, our sanctuary on a hot August day. I want to do boring.